Hi, hello, and welcome. It's me, Vignesh here, and this is your favorite V and Data channel. In the last video, we saw what is decision tree. As a continuation of it, today we'll be seeing decision tree classification and regression, how to code it in Python using scikit-learn or sklearn. For that, let's pass on to a video. As I told you before, today we'll be seeing decision tree algorithm, how to code in Python. For that, first of all, we need a dataset. Classification and regression included in the same dataset, we are going to take it. This is a diabetes dataset. This is the target variable. These are the features for classification alone. I'm saying outcome is the target variable, other things are the features. For diabetes, same, right? We'll be seeking for a regression as well. We have removed the outcome for it. Pregnancy has been taken as the target variable, and other variables are taken as the regression for regression features, right? That is a regression. That is not a classification problem. So pregnancy is taken as a target variable for the regression problem. The outcome is taken as the value for the target variable for the classification problem. Now, first of all, for the classification decision tree, right? The packages needed for it are import pandas as PD. We are importing the pandas data frame or data structure. We are importing as PD, and then sklearn.tree import decision tree classifier. Why classifiers, right? We are taking decision tree classifier. This is a classification problem. So we are using decision tree classifier. For the model selection, right? Sklearn import train test split. We are going to segregate the data into train and test split. Then from sklearn import metrics. This is for calculating the accuracy of the algorithm or the model which we have created with the help of the training and testing data. With the help of the tested data and predicted data. The data is in the VA data, code and files, data, diabetes.csv. It is a CSV format, so we are using pd.read.csv. Now we are printing the head of the data. Top columns, right? Top of five rows will be printed, all the columns will be printed. Feature column is pregnancy, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI, diabetes, PD, till age. Okay? These are the features which we are going to use. That is the X value. Outcome is the target variable, so it is assigned to the Y. We are passing all the features to the X and Y is the outcome. So we are passing the outcome to the Y alone. After that, right, we are splitting into train, test, and train test split. Train test split with the help of X and Y data. We are splitting the test size is 3. That is 30% is for the test size and 70% is for the 70% is for the training size. And random state is 1. It is split into X train, X test, Y train, Y test. Now, CLF. We are passing the decision tree classifier maximum depth equal to 5, that to a variable called CLF. Like max depth is the number of nodes from top till down is 5. For example, I have given 5. It's kind of hyper parameter in the decision tree classifier. There is maximum feature, maximum node, and so on. CLF1 is CLF.fit X train Y train. Now I'm fitting it to the decision tree classifier, the training data to the decision tree classifier, X train and Y train. After fitting it, right, I'm giving a Y predict variable and passing it to the, I'm passing it as clf.predict X test 1. With the help of the X test data, I'm predicting the Y predict. After that, right, I'm finding out the accuracy.metrics.accuracy score. With the help of the predicted Y predict as well as the already we are having the X Y test value. With the help of Y test and Y predict, we are getting the accuracy score. After that, from the decision tree, right? As we told, decision tree is a tree of structure. From matplotlib, import pyplot as PLT. That is a matplot. For that diagrammatic representation, we are going to use matplotlib. Import pyplot as PLT. From matplotlib, we are importing pyplot as PLT. From sklearn import tree, we are importing tree as well. FIG is a variable where PLTD figure is passed to it. Tree dot plot CLF1. CLF1 is the train data or the train model with the help of the training data. Tree dot plot tree CLF1. Then plot is shown. Okay. I'm also saving that figure, the showed figure, right? We're gonna save it at decision_tree.png. We are saving it as well. For this is a decision tree classifier. We shall run it now. Right click, run DTC. That is decision tree classifier. As I told you before, this is data set. Head, full value, pregnancy, glucose, blood pressure, diabetes, pedigree, pedigree function, age, outcome. After that, we are segregated to X and Y. We have entered the accuracy. Accuracy is 0.33. Because hyperparameter tuning is not done or the data is not processed, anything is not done. It's just a data. We are given a maximum depth of 5. Just like that. Okay. Now, this is the decision tree. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The maximum 3, 4, 5. We are given a maximum depth of 5. So it will come under 5. Okay. Top till bottom, there can be maximum of 5. Now we have closed it. Automatically the decision tree image will be shown, saved. That is because the fig.save we have saved it. Okay. Now we have reduced the maximum depth to 2. It is hyperparameter. We have changed the value to 5 to 2. After that we are running it again. Run DTC. Now you can see it, right? The accuracy has been increased from 0.3 to 0.6. That is nearly like 30% increase, like 30% increase from the first maximum depth of 5. So maximum depth 2 is changed. So the outcome accuracy is 0.6. Like, we will keep on tuning the hyperparameters one by one to get the accuracy to a certain limit. It will give you 100. This is for decision tree classifier. The maximum depth was given 5, so the nodes were from 0 to 5. Now we are given from 2, so it is 1 and 2. Last time we gave 5, now the maximum depth is 2. There are only 2 things. We'll close it now. After that, the image is saved as well. Decision tree classifier image is saved. This is about decision tree classifier. Today, we saw decision tree classifier, how to code it in Python using scikit or sklearn. This is about alone decision classification alone using decision tree. In the next video, we will see decision tree regression, how to use regression decision tree. Until then, it's me, Vignesh. Thank you.